What's up, sports fans? This is Bruce Blitz. This is definitely going to be my final blog on the steroid topic, so let me jump right into this. A lot of people are saying that Floyd is scared, and he's using the blood testing to get out of the fight with Manny. You've also said that Floyd is the first person to ever try to make his opponent take a blood testing program. Mike Tyson suspected Holyfield of steroid use, and Mike Tyson asked Holyfield to take a blood testing program in 1996. Holyfield agreed to the testing because he felt he had nothing to hide. The fight happened because of this. Evander Holyfield accused Mike Tyson of being a steroid user, but guess what? Tyson never sued him. Vinny Pazienza was accused of using steroids by many, but he never felt the need to put a lawsuit out there. Vitali Klitschko admitted to using steroids in the past. Roy Jones tested positive for Andro in 2000. This was the only time he tested positive for any substance. But his opponent, Richard Hall, also tested positive for the same substance. So what's that mean? It was a level playing field. Tommy Morrison was never caught. He admitted to using steroids. Recently, Canadian conditioning coach Valerio Mascariello has been banned for 12 years for administering steroids. Mascariello admitted he gave steroids to a female boxer, Amanda Gale, who was coincidentally banned for 2 years last April for testing positive for steroids. Shane Mosley admitted to using the cream in the clear, which is what Barry Bonds used. He got these performance enhancers from the same trainer that Barry Bonds did, Victor Conte, which Mosley said he didn't know what he was using. He thought it was just a supplement. Victor Conte responded by saying he never misled or deceived any athlete. And Conte said he's always been a man of full disclosure. In other words, he basically said Shane's full of crap. Mosley also took EPO, which is another performance enhancer that increases your endurance. Mosley's trainer, Daryl Hudson, was aware of what Mosley was taking. And Hudson took a list of the substances Mosley was taking before the Nevada State Athletic Commission, before his fight with De La Hoya. And guess what? The Nevada State Athletic Commission told Mosley's trainer that he wasn't using any banned substances. And people wonder why Floyd wants an outside party to do the testing. Here's another fact you might find interesting. Despite using these performance enhancers, mysteriously, Mosley never tested positive for anything. Mariano Carrera, Javier Castillejo, Orlando Salido, Francois Botha, Fernando Vargas, James Toney, Danny Batchelder, Cruz Carbajal, Michael Trubant, Omar Nino, and many others have tested positive for steroids. It's a problem in all sports, folks. Dr. Margaret Goodman said, "The reason most fighters use anabolic steroids is not for bulk. It's not the big heavyweights that are testing positive. It's the smaller weights. And there's always been this misperception that they're used to put on bulk. Whereas in reality, they're used by athletes so they can train more. You don't take anabolic steroids or human growth hormone all the time. You take them in a certain cycle in which you build muscle. You build strength, you build reflexes, and then you stop the cycle. So, with correct knowledge, someone shouldn't get caught," according to Flip Pomanski, a former ringside physician and Nevada State Athletic Commissioner. I want you to notice what he said. So, with the correct knowledge, someone shouldn't get caught. He also said, "Only the fighters who make mistakes are caught." Think about what he's saying. With the right knowledge, or foreknowledge of a potential upcoming test, you will be able to beat these tests. The only way to catch people is not to just test them during competition, but to test them between competitions, said Pomanski. And if boxing wants to get serious, then when people apply for a license in a state, or when people sign for a fight, now remember, he said this in January of the year that Oscar and Floyd fought. He went on to say, let's say Oscar and Floyd, they signed in December for a fight the next May. the state where the fight is going to be could insist on part of the language in the contract stating that they can be tested at any time. Now, a lot of you have said, and I'm talking to the people who dislike Floyd and the people who are infatuated with Manny, that random tests don't matter. Hey, Manny agreed to do a test 24 days before the fight and after the fight. Why would Manny picking his test dates matter? Now, after what I just told you that these experts said, is it starting to make more sense? Mark Fainaru-Wada, who is a San Francisco Chronicle reporter, and he's a co-author of The Game of Shadows, this is what he said. Knowledge is half the deal. If you know when you're going to be tested, that kind of defeats the purpose. Okay, now Richard Pound is of the World Anti-Doping Agency, and he said, you need to have the random testing as part of your arsenal. Paulie Malignaggi, Kermit Cintron, Andre Berto, and Floyd Sr. all have stated their suspicions about Manny Pacquiao using steroids. Now let's keep in mind that Freddie Roach did train James Toney while he was on steroids. I'm sure there are probably many reasons why they feel this way about Manny, and I'm sure word of mouth probably has something to do with it. If you are an avid boxing fan, you know that we saw a new Manny Pacquiao versus David Diaz. In the fight 3 months prior to that fight, Manny fought Juan Manuel Marquez, and he looked sluggish. Most of us thought Manny had hit the point in his career where he was going to start to decline. Sudden magically, Manny comes back to fight Diaz, and he looks like a peaked out 22-year-old fighter who's able to be a high-volume puncher, all of a sudden with more power. We've had all kinds of excuses, folks. We've heard that Manny Pacquiao's afraid of needles, but he's got tattoos. We've heard that Manny Pacquiao has superstitions about giving blood close to fights, but we've seen video of him happily giving blood for a regular sports physical 14 days before a fight. We've heard that Manny Pacquiao is weakened by giving blood. But come on, folks, this is boxing. Boxers get cut all the time in the course of a bout. People believe that Pacquiao lost to Morales because of a blood test. But Manny knew he was going to be taking a blood test. And has anyone even taken the time to entertain the thought that Manny might have gone to that fight off a performance enhancer? And the fact that he didn't use enhancers before the fight are the reasons why he was so sluggish in the bout, instead of buying into everything that Manny puts out there. This is an era of performance enhancement users. And every single performance enhancement user lies about their use until they are pinned up against the wall. I'm not saying Manny is using. I am saying we will never know if he's clean or not until he agrees to a year-round random Olympic-style drug testing program. Manny's own strength and conditioning coach, Alex Ariza, said, Manny doesn't know what he takes. I make special blends and I give it to him to take, but he has no idea what it is. If Manny's own strength and conditioning coach said Manny doesn't know what he takes, how can Manny himself be so sure that he's not taking steroids? I also find this statement contradictory, because if Manny is afraid of giving blood, how could a person so cautious about giving blood not know what he's putting into his own body? We suspected Bonds, McGwire, Palmeiro, Sosa, A-Rod, and many more for gaining power, size, speed, and endurance. Manny Pacquiao has moved up 8 weight divisions in his career, and all of a sudden it's not fair for us fans to question him because he's so popular? You don't pass up $30 to $40 million over giving up a teaspoon of blood, especially if you have nothing to hide. And especially when boxing is a sport where fighters frequently bleed in the ring anyways. So if Manny gets cut, should they stop the fight because he might be weakened by the cut? Manny should take random blood tests for the Clottey fight if he really wants to clear his name, instead of trying to cash in with a lawsuit on what potentially could just be a good job by Manny of hiding his use of PEDs. The biggest problem I see is that people hate Floyd and love Manny so much that they aren't willing to really take a look at what's going on. I have a strong feeling if Floyd was the one in question, people would just assume he's on steroids without even looking at the facts of the matter. We don't know for sure one way or the other. There sure are a lot of factors that are pointing to the strong potential that Manny's hiding something. But to blanketly say that you know he's not doing anything because you like him, and to say that Floyd was using this blood testing to duck the fight, to me, it shows a lack of IQ. And that's the bottom line, because Bruce Blitz said so.